Hello friends, in this tutorial I'll be talking about Madaline. So let us discuss what is Madaline first, then we'll look at the training algorithm and then we'll jump on to the question. So what is Madaline? Madaline is a model which consists of many Adaline in parallel with a single output unit. Now, I'll explain all these points with the help of the diagram. See, this is the architecture for the Madaline layer. This is the input layer. This is the hidden layer, or it is also known as the Adaline layer. And this is the Madaline layer which consists of a single output unit. During the training process, what we do is we apply weight updation between the input layer and the hidden layer, while the weights between the hidden layer or Adaline layer and Madaline layer, they remain fixed, positive, and they possess equal values. Okay, so now let us look at the training algorithm for Madaline. Step number one is to initialize the weights. Set initial small random values for Adaline weights, also set initial learning rate alpha. Step 2 is to calculate the net input to the each hidden Adaline unit by the formula Zin j equal to bj plus sigma xi wi. Now we need to calculate the output of the each hidden unit. The step 4 is to find the output of the complete network. And the step 5 is to calculate the error and update the weights. See, if this is the diagram from Madaline, then what we do is we first of all calculate the net input to each hidden input unit. Then we by applying the activation function, we calculate the output for each hidden input unit, and then we calculate the net input to the output of the complete network, and then we after applying the activation function, we calculate the output of the complete network, and then we compare the value with the target value. If target value is equal to the output value, then we need not apply weight updation. Hence, otherwise we need to apply weight updation. But here also two cases arise, when t value is plus 1 and t value is minus 1. When t is not equal to y and t equal to plus 1, we need to apply weight updation where the net input is closest to 0. That is, we need to apply weight updation only on the hidden input unit where the net input is closest to 0. How do we apply? Let's see, wij new equal to wij old plus alpha into 1 minus zin j xi, where x is the input, zin j is the hidden input unit, 1 is the target value, alpha is the learning rate which we'll assume in the question, w old is the old value of weight. If t is not equal to y and t equal to minus 1, then we need to apply a weight updation only on the units whose net input is positive. By the rule, w new equal to w old plus alpha minus 1 minus z in k into xi. Now target value is minus 1, so we'll write minus 1 here instead of 1. So now let us look at the question, you'll get to know about it better. See, using Madaline network, implement XOR function with bipolar inputs and targets. Assume the required parameters for training of the network. Now see, since XOR function cannot be directly implemented, we need to have the hidden input. Therefore, we use Madaline network to train the network. Okay, so let us first discuss the truth value x1, x2, t. The output of the XOR function is high when one of the input is high and the other is low. That means this is a odd function. So see, 1 1 minus 1, 1 minus 1 1, minus 1 1 1, minus 1 minus 1 minus 1. Now first step is to initialize the weights as w11 w21 b1 equal to 0.05 0.2 0.3. See, these are this is the input unit, this is the hidden input unit, and this is the output unit. See, why do we have only two input units in the hidden layer? See, the function for this XOR can be written as y is equal to x1 x2 bar plus x2 x1 bar. So see, this represents z1 and this represents z2. So therefore we need to have two hidden input units here. So we'll initialize the weights like w11 equal to 0.05, w121 equal to 0.2, w12 equal to 0.1, w22 equal to 0.2. And since the Adaline layer is connected to the output layer with the fixed weight, therefore we have assumed 0.5, 0.5 and 0.5 here, right? So now let us see for the first input sample, that is x1 equal to 1, x2 equal to 1, t equal to minus 1 and alpha equal to 0.5. Calculate the first step was to calculate the net input to the hidden unit. So we'll calculate the net input, that is Zin1 equal to b1 plus x1 w11 plus x2 w21. So we'll get 0.55 value, that is 0.3 plus 1 into 0.05 plus 1 into 0.2, 0.55. Similarly for Z2 we'll calculate how B plus X1 W1 2 plus X2 W2 2, that is we'll get 0.45 value here. Now next step was to calculate the output of Z1, Z2 by applying the activation. So activation function is given by f of Zn equal to 1 when Zn is greater than or equal to 0 and minus 1 when Zn is less than 0. Since both the values here are positive, therefore we'll get 1 value here. So Z1 equal to 1 and Z2 equal to 1. Now next step is to apply activation function over the net input Yn to calculate the output of Y. See, first of all we need to calculate the net input. That is, we have got 1 here. We have got 1 here. So what we'll get? 1 into 0.5 plus 1 into 0.5 plus 0.5. That is equal to 1.5. Now apply activation function. F of y and f of 1.5 equal to 1. Since for values greater than 0, we get 1. So the net output we have got is 1. Now since t value is minus 1 but is not equal to y. So we need to apply weight updation. But we'll see which case will it be. It is t equal to minus 1. Therefore, we need to apply weight updation only on that hidden input where we have the positive net input. But here, we have positive net input for both the cases, that is 0.55 and 0.45. So let us update the weights on both the hidden input units. That is W11 nu equal to W11 old plus alpha t minus Zn1 x1. That is 0.05 plus 0.5 minus 1 minus 0.55 into x1. After putting in the values, you'll get the value of W11 nu as minus 0.725 for W12 nu. Similarly, proceeding on the similar fashion, you'll get minus 0.625. For B1 nu, you'll get minus 0.475. For W21 nu, you'll get minus 0.575. For W22 nu, you'll get minus 0.525. For B2 nu, you'll get minus 0.575. Okay, so now see, for the second sample, x1 equal to 1, x2 equal to minus 1, and t equal to 1. First step, calculate net input to the hidden unit. So same step, Zn1 equal to B1 plus x1 W11 plus x2 W21. So we'll get B1 value is minus 0.475 plus 1 into 0.725 plus minus 1 into minus 0.575. You will get minus 0.625. Similarly for Zn2, you will get minus 0.675. Now apply activation function for the hidden input unit. You will get, since both the values is less than 0, therefore we will get the output as minus 1 and minus 1. Now apply net activation function over the complete network. You will get minus, since this value is minus 1. So you will get minus 1 into 0.5 plus minus 1 into 0.5 plus the bias value which you have got. Plus bias value 0.5, so you'll get minus 0.5. So after applying the activation function, we'll get minus 1 value. That is for the output of the complete network. Now see, target value is 1. Target value is 1, but here we have got is minus 1. So target value is not equal to y. So we need to apply weight updation. But now since t equal to 1, therefore we need to apply weight updation on Z1 and Z2 where net input is closest to 0. Now look at the Zn1 value and Zn2 value. Here it is minus 0.625 and here it is minus 0.675. So which value is nearest to 0? Zn1 is nearest to 0. So we'll apply weight updation only on Z1 and not on Z2. So how we will do that? W11 new equal to W11 old plus alpha t minus Zn x1. So W11 old becomes the W1 new in the previous case, that is minus 0.725, okay, plus 0.5 into 1 minus Zn1 value is minus 0.625 into 1. It will get 0.0875. Similarly for W21 new, you'll get W21 old is minus 0.575, you'll get minus 1.39. For B1 new, you'll get 0.34. While W12, since we are not applying weight updation on the second hidden input, therefore we'll get W12 new same as W12 old equal to minus 0.625 and W22 new equal to minus 0.525 and B2 new equal to minus 0.575. So after covering all the sets of the input, epoch 1 is set to be completed. And what are the final values that you will get is, these are the final values that you will get after completion of the epoch 1. X1, X2, T, Zn1, Zn2, Z1, Z2, Y in Y, W11, W21, B1, W12, W22, B2. So these are the values which you will get finally. So friends, if you like the video, please like, subscribe and share. Thank you.